Welcome to an example on how to graph a parabola when the vertex is not at the origin and the parabola opens left or right. Looking at the given equation, notice how we have a y squared term, but we only have x raised to the first. And this is the reason why the parabola will open left or right. In order to find the key components of the parabola, we want to write the equation in this form here. So looking at the left side in terms of y, we want this to be a perfect square trinomial, and then we'll factor the right side. So we'll have to complete the square on the left side. So we'll have y squared plus 8y plus a constant will equal negative 4x minus 16 plus the same constant. So to complete the square on the left, we're going to take half of the coefficient of y, or half of 8, and square it. Well, half of 8 is 4. 4 squared is equal to 16. So to make this a perfect square trinomial, we'll add 16 on the left. Then of course, to maintain equality, we'll have to add 16 on the right as well. So now we'll factor this. It should be a perfect square trinomial. The factors of y are y and y. The factors of positive 16 that add to positive 4 would be 4 and 4. So we have plus 4 and plus 4. And then on the left side, notice how we have minus 16 plus 16. So we're just left with negative 4x. So we can write this as the quantity y plus 4 squared. And then for the right side, to make it fit this form perfectly, I'm going to go ahead and write this as negative 4 times the quantity x minus 0. The reason this might be helpful is that the coordinates of the vertex will be hk. And since we have the quantity x minus 0, the x coordinate of the vertex is 0, and because we have the quantity y plus 4, the y coordinate of the vertex would be negative 4. And now to determine whether the parabola opens left or right, we want to determine the sine of a. If a is positive, the parabola opens to the right as we see pictured here. If a is negative, the parabola opens to the left. So again, going back to the form of the equation, notice that 4a must equal negative 4. Well, if 4a equals negative 4 and we divide both sides by 4, notice that a is equal to negative 1. So if a is equal to negative 1, that means the parabola will open to the left along the negative x-axis. So even though our notes below here show a parabola opening to the right, we can still use the information listed here to help us find these key components. But to help us do this, let's go ahead and plot our vertex and make a rough sketch of a parabola that opens to the left. And then once we find all these key components, we'll make a better graph at the end. So 0, negative 4 would be here. This would be the vertex. And the parabola opens to the left, so it would look something like this. The reason this is helpful is we know that the focus must be inside the parabola. In this case, since the parabola opens to the left, the focus would be to the left of the vertex, and the directrix would be to the right of the vertex. And the distance from the vertex to the focus is equal to the opposite value of a, and so is the distance from the vertex to the directrix. And since a is equal to negative 1, and the opposite value of negative 1 is positive 1, that means that the focus will be 1 unit to the left of the vertex here. This would be our focus. And the directrix would pass through a point 1 unit to the right of the vertex, so it would pass through this point here. Therefore, the directrix would be this vertical line. So just by looking at the coordinate plane, we can see that the coordinates of the focus would be negative 1, negative 4. The formula says to add a to the x-coordinate of the vertex, find the coordinates of the focus. Notice that 0 plus negative 1 is negative 1. And then the equation of the directrix, or this vertical line here, would be x equals positive 1. And the formula says subtract a from the x-coordinate of the vertex to obtain this equation. Notice that 0 minus negative 1 is equal to positive 1. But I think it's much easier to just understand the geometry of this and then use the coordinate plane to find this information. For the equation of the axis, or axis of symmetry, it's going to be a horizontal line passing through the vertex of the parabola. You can also think of this as a line that cuts the parabola in half, or the line for which the parabola is symmetrical across, meaning if we fold it across this line, it matches up perfectly with the other half. So for our graph, this would be the axis of symmetry here. Notice the horizontal line in the equation would be y equals negative 4. Notice this is the same as the y-coordinate of the vertex and the focus. And now we'll find the endpoints of the latus rectum, or focal diameter, which is this green segment here. It's parallel to the directrix, passes through the focus, and both endpoints are on the parabola. The focus is also the midpoint of this segment, and the segment has a length equal to the absolute value of 4a. So going back to our equation, notice that 4a was equal to negative 4. The absolute value of negative 4 is positive 4. So the length of the latus rectum is 4 units. And since the focus is the midpoint of the latus rectum, one endpoint would be 2 units above the focus here, and one endpoint would be 2 units below the focus here. So this would be the latus rectum, or focal diameter. And again, looking at the coordinate plane, we know one endpoint would be negative 1, negative 6. And the other endpoint would be negative 1, negative 2. Another way to obtain these coordinates would be to add and subtract 2 from the y-coordinate of the focus. Notice that negative 4 plus 2 is negative 2. Negative 4 minus 2 is negative 6. But because these endpoints are on the parabola, we can now make a better graph of our parabola. Using the vertex and the two endpoints, the parabola would look something like this. I hope you found this helpful.